Now mind the DJ. Please, a round of applause for the DJ, ladies and gentlemen. A round of applause for them. You know, DJs, so many people said a lot of things about DJs last night, and I can see that that is true. When DJs never top, wo balance elofin sere emi njo iwo palu ah oti lonu so gbadun sayo mo si o. Please, people, they talk something. Ibadan gini so mi gbo Ibadan gini so kile de lana kile ijoko kusinsia yo da fun ti opo e pa tewo fun raye. People say a lot of things about Ibadan. They say Ibadan people, when want a man shekpeju, is a lie. An Ibadan person will simply ask you a question when you go beyond your boundary. Step on an Ibadan man at the bus stop, you say, ah, ogbeni sayo mosio. Soju re funny. To ba jeun se ori ran. Okoju re apo. Aye tin si oto mo. E pa tewo fun raye. Please, if you are a mother or a father or an aspiring parent, can you please put your hands together for yourselves? Clap for yourself. Clap, oh! I can understand. Some of you will not clap because you never had this kind of upbringing. Clap! I know. Ah, it's good. You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. Now, Shete came here and said a whole lot of things about growing up. Growing up for me was very interesting. Very interesting. Very interesting. My father, who your papa sabi beat well? If you know your daddy knows how to flog, or if you are a father and you know how to beat a child, can you please wave your hand? My papa beats me one day. My spirit came out of my body and said, ah, daddy, how far? I said, you party. Ah, my father will beat you here. Somebody molete will hear and say, ah, daddy, I said, I'm going to kill us. Say, what, Lupani? Now, people used to say something, because today is Sunday, I'm going to drop two and I'll leave this place. Now, to all men of God here present, I say a very big thank you for coming around. Please, a round of applause for them. Pastor Francis, thank you for coming around. I like it. That guy that was talking to you yesterday never knew that you are a man of God. Anytime I am standing in a crowd where you are, I don't want to misbehave. Because if I pass my boundary, you don't need to fight your battle. There is the way the spirit does it. The mic could go off, make my career not go fall. Now, how many of you want to believe the fact that there are differences between a church and a church? Am I right or right? There are big differences between, a whole lot of difference between a church and a church. I am a product of the two. You can see, somebody looked at me and said, 13 disciples, what's wrong with you? I say, I eat too much of peacock these days. So you can call me comedy peacock. You see, I look myself, wear yellow, wear brown, wear blue, wear purple. I look at myself, am I all right? Now, in a church, when someone from a church speaks in tongues, it looks constructive. Am I right or right? It looks as if it is written. You hear something like, it's not joke, my spirit, the God slap me. Daddy, please intercede. Be interceding for me. You hear something like Lakos Maktuyada Ruzeve. And you people will say amen. Am I right or right? But in a source, when we want to speak in tongues, it's different. You hear something like, ah, Efede Foni. Ogun Timba Injako, Ogun Togba Yoba, Ofede Orunfo. Yaka, ya, 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 yaka. Kila yate or yata. Now, I tell you, prayer point in a church is very interesting. When pastors raise prayer points, you pray. But in a church, you can decide not to pray because you look at it and say, man, what is Pastor Francis talking about? I just want a contract of 10 billion naira. You might choose not to pray. But in a church, wallahi, won't be in that kemagbadra. When you hear prayer points like, Iwo wo lo wa mbi to gun aye e duro seyin bi ta snap for do mewa ti o gba trophy. Ah, wa gba adura sir. Would you pray? Pastors in the church, they use what is happening around us for us and we pray. You hear something like, ah, gbogbo ogun layo le Messi tabi Luis Suarez ti mbu ogo si Ronaldo aye e je mo ni ko gbe na sonu adura da. You pray. Now, in my church those days, our prayer point looks much like fundraising. My pastor one day just came to the altar and said, Lenny, agbadua, sir. Mommy, agbadua. Agbadua, says, off, eh? Iwa wo lo ni 5 naira ni bi oya no soke. Everybody came out with 5 naira. Praise the Lord. He said, oh, agbadua, Olodumare, 5 naira. Lowo to kere ju lori Nigeria to ma foju rubbish. Gbogbogun tin foju rubbish bi 5 naira da. Ah, adua ko ma gbe na sonu. Oruko Jesu. By the time we pray, you see people praying with force. They say, eh, emi ati 5 naira. Baba, you know, bo, orun, tino bo, emi, tino bo. After the prayer point, pastor will just say, oh, sir, egba gbogbo ejo. They'll collect everything. They'll put it in a bowl in front of the altar. You hear another one, iwa wo lo wa nbi pelu 10 naira. It now looks to me as if we were going for Idano in Yoruba land. You know, they were asking to bring out the denomination. So everybody brings out 10 naira again. They say, awo wo la wo 10 naira. They say, awo pupa ni sa. Ah, but auntie, ogbadua, gbogbogun to nje ka san po mo Olorun bi 10 naira. Orun ti na bo danu, adura. In a case whereby you are wearing a red cloth, just like my sister here, you see the way she will, ah! Especially when she's single. It's only, ah! Ah! Gbogbogun to je ka san po mo Olorun. Arun fire! Fire! After the prayer, pastor will say, oh, sir. Hold on, please, you know me. I don't bag gbogbo ejo. They will collect it. We move on to 20 naira. They say, no, you have no 20 naira. It's okay. Our woran talo wa no 20 naira. They say, our woran muri talamu wa me. Say, ah, oh, wa agbadura, gbogbogun to fe da yi elegbodo. Ba se pa muri talamu wa me da no. Oh, ni kon no ti no bo. Adura da. Nobody wants to die. We move on like that. Pastor will say, oh, yeah, bag gbogbo ejo. After that one, we move to 1,000 naira. Sayo Mosio. So you go jabo. Or to Lassidi. You hear? Iwa wo lo ni 1,000 naira ni bi. All of us had 1,000 naira. We raise it up. We say, oh, agbadua.
13.
Say, suru. Say, osi. Say, you call me wa bini. Wa den pari se ti mo gbowo re o. You hear? 1,000 naira. Lo wo to ni laju Nigeria. Gbogbogun to ni ko ma sori re bi 1,000. Oya orun ti na bo adura da. After the prayer point, pastor says again, Osa, etun gba gbogbo ejo. And I collected everything, put it on the altar. And I said, nibayi, apo losu agutan wa. How many of you have been chanced to listen to Pastor Paul Adefarasin? Ah, Pastor Paul, you know the way he talks with charisma. Even if you don't get anointing, you will get by his voice. Yeah, apo Pastor Paul Adefarasin, come about and bless your offering. Immediately, Pastor Paul gets on the altar and says, ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Come and tell your neighbor something is about to happen. Pretend as if you are in church, sir. Uh-huh. Come and do something crazy for God. Everybody will start doing something crazy. Pastor Paul had forgotten that this is a church, not a church. Do something crazy for God in a church like that of a bridge network. You hear people say, oh, hallelujah. People will carry plastic chair, raise it up. In a church, there is no plastic chair. Share on your back. You hear Pastor Paul say, come and do something crazy. One guy from the back of the church just shouted, oh, no! Do something crazy. Come and do something crazy. One guy stood up from the crowd, ran to the bishop's wife. He said, mommy, that one say, eh? He said, mommy, he said, grab bishop's wife by the head. Gave her hot French kiss. Mwah! Pastor Paul said, yeah, I can feel that spirit moving. Jacob, shut up. He moved to the bishop. He said, daddy, that was it. He said, daddy, he said, Saba! Pastor Paul said, yeah, I can feel the fire burning. And I looked at myself. I said, Emiwanko, as I grabbed the offering bowl, Pastor says, are you most here? Thank you so very much. The thing
he said. Disciple, ladies and gentlemen.
Please, we.